The next kidnapping was certainly no hoax. A wealthy local Muslim, 28-year-old Ahmed Ali Hassan Vali, is being held hostage until a £200,000 ransom is paid.
I'm quite far from Johannesburg at the moment. I'm coming from the western side of Johannesburg.
With a policeman posing as a friend of Ahmed's, negotiations have just begun. The kidnappers have no idea that the whole conversation is being run by the police.
The money must be in the house.
In the house?
Yes.
Where about drop it at Sabera's house?
Yes, now the money must be there.
Okay, listen here.
Already there.
The people are already there?
Yes.
Yeah, but I want to see Ahmed first. I must see, you see, I've got the money with me, and I must see Ahmed before I hand the money to you.
Listen to you. Come to me. When I speak to you, you fucking listen, that's all. You go fucking drop the money and don't involve yourself, because I promise you, I swear to Quran, I will fight you up tonight. I don't want Ahmed, I'll want you.
No, I have to see.
Watch out, all right?
No, you can't
watch
insist.
Out, because I'm going to fuck you up and I'll fuck up all your fucking family, all right?
Listen, why are you being rude to me? Why are you being rude to me? Because me, I'm only doing a favor for Sabera.
Don't fuck with
I'm only a friend of Sabera. I believe you.
Love.
I believe
There's
you.
No money after half an hour in the house.
I believe you. Okay, I understand. Okay, what about the safety? What about the safety? What about the safety?
The more you play with us, the more we fuck him up. Sabera last night, she said, in the morning she finished. Because we're supposed to start to cut his fingers and send to you people in the envelope. You need that? We'll do it tonight.
Okay, I've got the whole 2 million rand with me. Okay? I'm not a stupid person, okay? I'm worried about my safety, and I'm worried about the safety of Ahmed.
Put the money at the house, and that's all.
Okay, I'll do that. I will do that then.
You'll do that.
Okay.
It's better for you, I'm telling you. I swear to God.
But I must...
Put the money after half an hour.
But first of all...
You're going to be injured. I'm telling you from now, and you don't want that. Don't think you're far from John, because I get you, will get you wherever you be. And I know which car you're driving. That's your thing, because I get that station, I'll get you address.
I'm worried about my safety. And what about Ahmed? What about Ahmed?
It's your fucking problem. We're going to take the money and then it'll be free.
Listen here, I want to know what's happening about Ahmed. I need to know. I must see him. I have to see Ahmed. Bye, Afanai.
What is your name?
Okay, no, you're doing fine. You're doing perfect. What? We have got no deal. He wants the money. So we have no deal unless we see Ahmed. But you're doing very great.
A surveillance team has traced the whereabouts of the gang and is monitoring their every move.
One of the guys in the group fits the description of Ahmed. So I just want to make sure now if it is Ahmed. So we're just going to wait, make sure for the description, and we're going to move out. If they move to another place or maybe to a house, the observation teams will let us know. And if they maybe in while they're moving in transito, we just move in and just bust them on the road.
2 hours later, and the surveillance officers have followed the kidnappers to a house in Johannesburg. The task force is ready to go into action. But the house has its own surprises. As the team scales the back walls, it hits an electric fence and triggers the house alarm. They've now got to get to Ahmed as soon as possible. The shouting is a deliberate tactic. It allows the elite team to dominate the room using their voices rather than their guns.
On your back.
I think they can bullshit us.
The operation was concluded so swiftly that none of the suspects had time to draw their weapons.
Are you all right? What's your name?
Ahmed.
Ahmed?
Ahmed.
What's wrong, my lord? You want to?
Sean. Yeah, okay, good news, John.
It's all Sean.
Are you all right?
Yes.
Any injuries? You're right, okay.
It's Mr. Combat himself.
11 men arrested in connection with the suspected kidnapping of a Mpumalanga man will appear in court in Groblersdal tomorrow. Police spokesperson Mark Reynolds says the 11 were arrested by a special task team in Alberton on the East Rand last night. The 11 suspects include 4 Palestinians, 2 men from Jordan, and 1 each from Iraq, Turkey, Mozambique, Lebanon, and South Africa.
Democratic South Africa today has become a haven for criminals of all nationalities. In a police force numbering 130,000 officers, there are just 95 operational members of the special task force.
Boys.